cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talkin' sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they louder, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the 1,000, boy. They get you touch, and they get you foul, boy. I'm talking, you out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, Rich be snapping. I say the collar, boy. I'ma lose the roof and the stain. Please don't test me like on that boy, Jenny. And ain't talking dang. It's like everything, look, cut them drop. They go insane, they wanna pitch. Ain't gon' get in the beef, I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. How that's your girl, and she in my rental. We had cable, we ain't even have no tunnels. They change the channel and they see me. I'm signing deals and I don't bleed. Burglary, B&E. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. That's my sweet, but I be switching. It's depending on the week. Christian Louis, red bottle, them, I think I cut my feet.
They talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. I wonder where that low is at. It was me against the wall. I was out here running plays. Guess it paid off after all. 13, bad girl, her hat just got a star. She got it stitched and I got it stitches. We won't be sparing you. Chasing who? Pursuing who? I won't be chasing you. I'm 4-1, I lost the cap. I'ma charge it to the game. 4-3-8 is not a game. It's just a music thing. Last player got out his lane. Put right back in his lane. I'ma sit that pat when I get to Cali.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their Dolphins emerging from the Hard Rock Stadium tunnels, and we are ready to go as the Dolphins get set to match up with the Indianapolis Colts. 2-1-2 teams, each hoping to get back to 500, and we're underway in week four. And here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And he will be brought down here in. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now the former Washington Husky, here's Myles Gaskin. And good yardage as he gets this one up to about the 23. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Now Tua. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. He's going to air one out. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll be taken down, but first he gets deep into Indianapolis territory.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't. But it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. From the gun, it's Tua. This is caught. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Tua finding Gesicki there for a Dolphin first. Gaskin. And he is in. Touchdown, Miami. Miles Gaskin. His second touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins take it right down and score on the opening drive. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Here comes Harris out of the end zone. No return there for Harris, and the drive will begin at the 25. Taylor's got the first down and more. And finally marked down at the 42-yard line. That one good for 33 and a first. Boy, the offensive line there, that was a thing of beauty to watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front, and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point by them. The timing on point. The run even better.
And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. 46 yards rushing for him now in his first two carries of the ball game. So first and 10 now from the 30. Throwing his wins. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Bernardrick McKinney muscled his way in for the sack. Throwing on second and long. Wentz. Throw going to be caught left side here by Granson. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 13-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11.
wins. And this will be swung out wide for Taylor. Touchdown, Colts! Jonathan Taylor, his first touchdown on the year. And the Colts have tied things up. They can take the lead with an extra point. CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. And here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
For most people, the excitement of the kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. And he's got his tight end. It's Mike Gesicki. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. A busy first quarter. His third catch of the afternoon is a first down. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
Bernard McKinney, the former Texan, there to make the stop. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. From the gun, it's Wentz. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. And down inside the 15 he goes. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
First and 10, Taylor now. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Byron Jones in there to make the tackle.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Throwing on second and 8, Wentz. They'll set up the screen to Taylor. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Colts are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Second and goal.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. Taylor is going to take this one in for a Colts touchdown. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Tua. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Tua gonna throw. Yeah, the pressure gets there, and Tua's going to be taken down. Quiddy Pay in there to record the second sack of his young NFL career. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and the lead is up to 15 now. Rodrigo Blankenship. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. Grant, he will not return it, and his guys will begin at the 25. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down. Tua now on first down. Over the middle, he's got Gesicki, the big 6'5 tight end. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. He was looking for Jalen Waddle there, but now it's third and goal. Tua sets up to pass it. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. The Colts D sticking to their assignments, and that brings up fourth.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
The kick by Sanders is good, and the Dolphins are going to be forced to settle for 3. So the 3 points there, and CD, that helps them inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. And we'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine...
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage. But I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. As he'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Wentz now on first down. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Nick Needham picks it off. And they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line.
So first thing that crossed my mind is, why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now.
Switch out, switch out. 58 in the line. 58 in the line. Let's go one more.
Looking to pass, Tua. And he'll get nothing out of that one. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. He'll look to throw. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Albert Wilson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Well, this could be a big turnaround. They get the touchdown here in the final moments of the second quarter. And remember, Charles, they're going to get the ball to start quarter number three as well.
So what you're saying is if they take the ball down to start the second half and score again, it could change the entire complexion of this game, couldn't it?
Absolutely. Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. This is caught. It's Kirk. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So we've come to halftime in a 5-point game. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Final preparations being made for the second half, both in terms of game plan and also hydration, because humidity is really going to catch up to these guys, no doubt. And for the call of the second half, we go back to Brandon Godd.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Second half ready to get underway. The Colts with a lead, and they will receive the football. Come to the line ready to start their next drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
6 yards the pick up, and that's a first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Wentz going to give this to Taylor. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 70 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
That's the type of run that Jonathan Taylor gives you so often, and you just can't take it for granted. He finds a way to get those extra yards. The third running back taken in the 2020 draft, but he had the best numbers by far of any of them. 1,169 yards, third most in the NFL, and by the last quarter of the season, he ranked among the best runners in the league.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Thank you. Grant. He's got Grantson, his tight end. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
I would say just add that one to the total of big plays he's already made here in the first month of the year. You've got to think the front office and the coaching staff have got to be excited about what they've seen so far and really excited about what they expect to see down the road.
Wentz now on first down. To the right side, complete to Taylor. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Wentz. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Now, Wentz again. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Their defense did its job, forcing the takeaway there to start the half, and now can the offense follow suit?
And you'd better believe that one side of the ball feeds off the work of the other, so they'll want to come out, establish some rhythm, and go down and take the lead.
After the turnover, it's Tua. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
On the handoff, it's Gaskin. Room to run for Gaskin. And he takes it across the 50 to the 46-yard line. 15 more yards there and quickly another first down. Tua now on first down. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one goes for 24 yards.
We saw this jumping jack make steady improvement his first 3 years in Miami. And he topped it off with 53 catches last year, career high. Now in his fourth season, I expect his numbers to continue to rise.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off at the 12. And this one will be brought back to the 22. Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Javon Holland coming up to make the stop. On play action, it's Wentz. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Running left, Taylor. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 90 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run-blocking abilities, and we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big gain.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash, too.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. Into the hands of his running back, Marlon Mack. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. If they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
So still 14 yards to go, second down. Shotgun now for Wentz. Oh, a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch.
We talk so often about how hard it is to win in the NFL when you turn the ball over, and here a late turnover leads to a fourth quarter touchdown and a two-score lead.
And what's more important is being able to take advantage when a turnover presents itself. You've got to come up with points to make the other guy pay. They're able to do so here, and they've got a pretty good chance now of winning this football game.
So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. And here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled it to 15. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. From the gun, it's Tua. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Kari Willis. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. They'll run on first down. It's Taylor. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 104 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
You get a rookie tight end who can run like this, it just gives this offense a different dimension than they've had. It's going to be fun to watch his development and how this offense expands as this season moves along.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll look to run with Taylor. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Jonathan Taylor, his third touchdown of the season, all coming in this game. And the Colts look like they're about to put an end to their two-game losing streak as they add on to their lead. Be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five.
Let's get activated. Let's get activated. Let's get activated. Let's get activated. Go QB in the pocket. Let it go. Them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real. Just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game. I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play. I'ma make a move.
Audible.